puts his hands on his shoulders. Magic.
It's a joke, guys.
You're too fucking late.
Nice place you got here, Jim.
Yeah, it's your bones.
Hi, babe.
Well, what the fuck does it mean then?
Do I have to spell it out for you? It's about the environment, taking care of our planet.
Whoa, you mean to tell me the song she's my cherry pie is about separating our garbage?
Yeah, fuck. Look, you got this cherry. It doesn't mean jack shit. You get a bunch of cherries, it still doesn't mean fuck all. But you squish them all together and you get this great pie. And you also get a bunch of fucking seeds. You throw them away? No. You plant them and give back to nature what you stole. It's a beautiful fucking cycle.
Yeah, but she's my cherry pie. I just don't get that line.
It must have been in the advanced courses at high school. Look, the world's your cherry. It's everyone's cherry. And you better start looking after it.
She's my cherry pie.
Sunday afternoons, yeah? The whole fucking family's sitting around the table. Everybody's tucking into grandma's cherry pie. Red.
Cherries are so expensive in Tokyo. Yesterday,
I went to the fruit shop. Mind?
I was trying to make some kind of point. Where the fuck was I?
You were talking about sitting around eating your grandma's cherry pie.
Yeah. So that's it. That's the fucking song. It doesn't take Einstein to work out. It's just a goddamn ode to grandma's cherry pie.
Isn't it just about a guy who is getting some major league pussy?
Yeah! Major league!
Okay guys, cool it. I've just spoken to the guy on the inside. The stuff has arrived, everything's a go today. Our target is on a way for a drink at his favorite pub. And he's got the stuff on him. Mr. Bones, Mr. Chekhov, Miss Sulu, Mr. Spock, take your position in the counter across from the pub.
Uhura,
put on your prettiest face. He'll never know what hit him.
Yeah, ain't that the truth, though?
Hey, look, I know this may seem like a fucking low-key assignment to you, but we all know this guy's history. He may seem like a fucking pushover, but if he had to, he'd cut his own kid's throat, so stay alert. Okay, we've got about 4 hours till this stuff's out of our reach, so let's make it happen, and make it happen fast, okay?
Jim, what's with these names?
Yeah, Chekhov is pretty close to Jackal.
Well, that really hurts coming from Lieutenant Whore.
Yes, to boldly go where so many men have come before.
Is there a special reason I'm through?
Other than it sounds like Mr. Screw You, I can't think of any.
Hey, Sulu's cool. Remember when he took off his shirt on the Enterprise and he rampaged through the ship with a sword?
Yeah, but so highly illogical, Bones.
Oh, shut the fuck up, Mr. Cobb. Why can't we just use colors?
It's binged up. Okay, guys, look. It's my way or the highway, all right?
Well, ream me up, Jim.
Yeah, any of you Klingons got a light?
Sleek, light, easily to disassemble. Properly concealed, get this past any hard-ass customs officer. Fully automatic, 9 rounds. Pneumatically drilled head, floating hammer. Beretta, 92F. Ideal for home defense, but for separating the street punk's head from the body.
You mean separating a rabbit's head from its body, don't you? This is a weapon a real man uses. Die cast body with floating trigger head. Double cartridge, auto safety locking system, solid titanium firing pin with a single thread cross lock. Pull the trigger once, put a hole the size of a baseball through anyone. Pull the trigger, get consecutive 10 round bursts, won't leave a piece even the size of a baseball. The Ingram Mach 10. Spock, perhaps you could challenge that.
Yes, well, The idea of a phased plasma rifle confounded scientists all the way through the 21st century, with the discovery in 2139 of dilithium crystals in the Gamma Knight system, were they finally able to generate a sufficiently strong blast of energy. By actually inverting the nodal points on the beta wave, the antimatter actually vaporized itself. This blast of pure energy was... It's just kind of a long slide 45. No laser sighting, but it works for me. Sulu.
Katana. Finger brain. Fuck you up.
I suppose that's one of the problems with dealing with a foreign country. Getting used to all their silly customs and ways of life. You know, I have a friend who was fondled 3 times on a train in Tokyo.
Oh, really?
Yeah, in one day. Not that I mind a bit of fondling. But I want to choose who does the touching, thank you very much. On a train by some sex-deprived samurai, bloody hell!
I heard some samurai carry big swords.
Not what I've heard. Mind you, the same woman did meet a rather impressive cherry farmer in Hokkaido.
See, you just gotta look around. Play the field, as they say. But I've heard it's pretty hard on foreign women living here.
Living here? God! You wouldn't catch me living here. No, I'm just in and out 3 or 4 times a month. How about you?
Oh, just passing through. You with British Airways or something?
Virgin.
Never flown Virgin. What are stewardesses like?
Don't you mean flight attendants?
Oh, right, sure. There aren't any Virgin stewardesses anymore.